All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to more Mr. Cat coverage for what could be the last game today. We could see a game number 3 in the series as well. I'm Android, being joined by Mottpax. What's up, man?
Hello.
Sorry, Trent. I still gotta learn, man.
Oh, it's fine.
You've been Mottpax to me for like 2 years.
Well, yeah. Well, that's life.
You feeling the tiredness?
I'm ready,
you've been up
Annie.
Since 3 a.m.?
Yeah, no, I guess same time, just different time here. I was up late helping on a friend's show thing, and then I had my ass whooped at friends with or golf with friends, which was pretty fun. But Annie, that doesn't matter because Magnus is back, and I don't know what's happening. Maneski, what's going on, guys?
Like,
I mean, they take the ogre. At least there's that.
Why wasn't Magnus banned?
Well, I can understand that Earth Spirit and Meepo are still scarier.
That's fair. Remaining. Warriors game and take, you know, no real hesitation. Just get in there, grab that up. They got their Rubik. I think this is Warriors. Just how clean they executed last game, I think this is going to be very difficult for Maneski to actually take it out from under them.
I concur. Do you concur, Annie?
I said it, so yeah.
You concur. Excellent.
Yeah.
Glad to hear it.
Sorry, right. Guys. We're a little bit sleepy here. Fourth consecutive game of Mr. Cat pretty early in the morning, but that doesn't mean these games are any less hype than any other. So, Maneski, what are they going to pull out with their Ogre Magoo? What big, strong core
What's
are we going to see?
What's the answer here? Have a strong lane. They will just
lane.
Do the Ember. Okay. All right. I didn't want to say it because I thought it was a little crazy this early in the draft, but the hero's strong. But you just had some problems. But I guess if they're that comfortable running him safe lane or mid, this is fine. In fact, I feel like when we see them, it's almost more often safe lane at this point for Maneski. So we'll see what they want to do.
Maneski, no hesitation. Go straight in for that Void ban. I love it. They've been thoroughly whooped in game number 1. They just immediately take it out. We talked about how it's pretty difficult to ban all of Magnus's potential partners because pretty much any, you know, melee position 1 is going to super benefit from that in power. But I guess Maneski just really can't stand that Void. He did such a good job getting Ember in the Chronosphere every time.
Oh, by the way, for everyone who's here for What the Duck.
Not here.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, we're going to lose most of our stream viewers about halfway through this game just because the announcements for the major will be happening at that point, and we're doing a live What the Duck of that. I have no idea what channel it's on.
It's going to be on Moonduck TV 2.
That would make sense. All right,
yes.
Moonduck TV 2, please.
So make sure, just
cast.
Go give that a follow.
Yeah.
You guys will figure out when that'll be on. So I just put it in the chat, which you'll see in 2 minutes. So, and as you said, they banned out the other one, the Jug. We lose our Shadow Fiend as they know this Ember could more than likely head into the mid, or rather the safe lane, and then open up the mid for said Shadow Fiend. But Warriors Gaming, poor position here. Where do they want to go? A little bit of control for the Ember could be a silencer, perhaps, with a Helmeted Dominator. I like that strategy. A little bit of Wombo combo potential as well with the Magnus helps ease the initiation onto the Ember Spirit since they won't have the Faceless Void this time, and that was such an important part of their last game. They could just go straight for the OD right now and force Maneski to start considering their other options, maybe moving to a Nyx Assassin or something like that.
Terror Blade.
Pudge is actually kind of okay.
Terror Pudge?
Terrifying Pudge.
Oh, they go.
Oh, my goodness.
Why was that still in the pool?
Apologies, folks.
Yeah, we slipped up. My golly. That is a good
You know what?
Again.
That's not on us, honestly.
That's
on
Maneski.
Making it the second phase. That can't be. That's not on us. So nice grab. Yeah. Just Maneski more concerned about those position 1 partners. Although I feel like that's exactly what we talk about with the falter of trying to play against this Magnus strategy is that it doesn't matter. Like they're just going to pick Slark or something and going to do all the same stuff, you know? And you're almost like wasting bans on these heroes that doesn't really matter who their buddies are. But speaking of Slarks and stuff, maybe the Disruptor, possibly an idea into that. And, well, just how many pages do WG want to rip out of the book here from Faceless? Do we just go for the old Wraith King, perhaps?
Let's do it.
Definitely a thought.
I missed that croissant beard. Now that you pointed it out, I can't unsee it.
Gotta see it again.
They're gonna go for the Lifestealer again with the Slardar. Very classic pairing. It's gonna do so well with the Magnus. I mean, Warriors just fish their wish on every part of this draft. That is scary to go up against Mineski. They've got another pick here. I mean, how do you handle this?
If you're Mineski, you see, like, you've only committed two supports and only one of your cores, so you have two full cores to work with, and now what you want to do is look at WG and say, what is their game plan, what are they going to do, and what heroes can we do to avoid it? We don't need to think of just straight hero counters at this point, I don't think. You want to start considering, all right, they need an Armlet up on the Slardar, and, or sorry, an Armlet on the Slicealer, and then Slardar, they're going to roam, they're going to try and get a blink onto the Slardar more than likely from the position 4 role, but that takes a little bit of time, so... We got some room to work with. We got like 10 minutes or so, 12 minutes. And then they're going to try and group up. They're going to try and fight all the time. And we can just try and dodge that. We can try and rat a little bit, have some more elusive heroes, that sort of an idea. But fortunately for WG, what the beauty of Magnus is that you're not locked into that gank strategy that we often see Slardar and Lifestealer suffer from, where they miss out on a couple infest bombs and they're wasting all this time. Because you have the Empower, he can just go right into the jungle and essentially have that Battle Fury. And he keeps farming, he keeps pace with your enemies. So even if you're missing on ganks and your opponents are like split pushing and farming the map and you start to get concerned, you can just fall back and be like, oh wait, my Lifestealer is going to go kill like 4 camps in 2 seconds here, and suddenly we're back on net worth evens again, right? So
that is well said. Whew, this is tough. I think Mineski, they've got to really pull it out here with that last pick, and their lanes have got to be clean. They can't give anything up. 10 seconds remaining. Let's see, last ban Warriors. Who are they scared of here? Who would you be? Ultra Frightened.
That's a good choice.
That is a Naga. Bold choice. I have not seen a Naga in a game for a while, but...
Yeah, Miracle. I mean, they'll still first ban Naga against this guy. Basically the original Naga Siren guy. But
dude,
that's the split push that we're talking
Naga
about,
Siren.
So...
That chat meme gets me every time. It's so stupid. Oh.
And there goes the OD, though. To be expected if they want to send the Ember Spirit mid. And, geez, you know, that if there's ever going to be a TB, this wouldn't be the... Well, it's kind of bad, but it's also kind of not. I'm at, like, an I'll allow it stage, basically.
Like a 3% chance of Terror Blade.
I think Morph is a hero that they like a lot in these same kind of scenarios.
Morph is scary because it's so boom or bust, and you already have the Ember Spirit that's kind of that, you know, can go one way or the other type hero.
Oh, I hear you.
I mean,
I can agree.
I think Mineski, they've got to execute whatever they do pretty perfectly to get it done. So I guess you can go with those high-risk, high-reward heroes, because if you don't get it off the ground, you're dead anyway. Well, we'll see. They're really eating this up, and they're going to go for a Slark themselves. I mean, that's a snowball, all right? I think if Mineski go in and they get, you know, 5 kills in a row, this is looking great for them. But Warriors, I think just with very strong lanes and clean rotations, might be able to get the upper hand.
Yeah, now with our... So we have our Magnus coming down bottom. 5 seconds. And probably a little bit of help from a Slardar. Some pressure in there. Not going to be the easiest time, I don't think, for the Magnus to actually pressure into that lane. So it should open up some room for the Ogre Magi to roam to the mid. Even just Disruptor and Slark should be able to control up the Magnus pretty well. You think about Surge and Skewer, and they're very similar. And that whole idea of how Darkseer is countered by Disruptor, Magnus should suffer from the same thing. So we look towards our mid lane anyway. And that 10-minute rotation, who can do well? Like your Pucks, your Queens, your Invokers... Just going to combo up with the Slardar, with the Sun Strikes, and a good counter to the Ember in the mid. Yeah, I guess you don't really want to pick your Pucks into Ember Spirits, so. Invoker it is, my friends. Wowzers. You guys ready for some Sun Strikes? What?
All right.
I didn't hear anything. Was it a spider?
Mod's trying to steal one of my XLR cables. He got it.
Oh.
So when you unplug it from the soundboard, it can make a very unpleasant noise. So I muted it for the lovely stream viewers, but you're about to get an earful if it was making anything, so. All right, anyway, there we go. Invoker finishes up the draft. Sorry, I was paying attention to Mott.
It's okay. All you missed was Sun Strikes. That's what we're going to get this game.
I am thoroughly prepared for this game. What are your odds? How are you feeling about it?
Think about the Sand King's lane. His blink should be relatively
got
okay.
Got the Sunstrike. You were right.
Oh, well. There you go. Wowzers. I don't know. A lot of this game from Ineska, it definitely rides that Shadow Blade and how much pressure is going to be down bottom, but I don't think Sark's going to have a problem. So this will be one of the rare times where Sark doesn't get heavily pressured just because the pick was later into the draft. They already have this Magnus that isn't the strongest laner and is a little bit greedier, so... I think Miracle should have a pretty good game, and then therefore, as long as RR gets a somewhat okay timing on his blink, then they're in a very good spot. I think they can kind of beat out that timing once again that we talked about with the Magnus from the previous game, where he spends all that time farming with the helm and the arcanes and doesn't quite have that blink dagger. If they can fight then and there with the Veil onto Bimbo, then I like their chances.
We'll see how it's going to go here. Everyone's shaping up. There is a nice dire ward here placed down again. I mean, is this a common ward spot? It feels like it should be, but I rarely see wards there. I feel like it's
which one? Sorry,
the Radiant Jungle near the little two camps.
Oh yeah, this is like the spot. This
yeah,
is where
I feel like
it.
I don't see it in competitive games because it's just so common that it's dewarded all the time.
Yeah, that's fair. It's definitely like the most common pub one too, so it's not unusual. Like, you always have to smoke if you want to play this in a pro game. There's, like, no way. And it's probably the first place you're going to check.
Invoker sufficiently bullied off of this, so another Bounty Rune is going to be going the way of the Radiant side. They take up three. So, Mineski getting a decent start as they head to their lanes.
Ben does his usual shenanigans.
We'll see if he gets away with it this time. There's some more Radiant heroes jumping in. Ben, he's having none of this. He's tethered in place, but he's still pumping that Slark out. And there we go. He's in some trouble there.
He's buying TPs.
He knows.
Buy another one.
He feels like it's his time.
Oh, Fairy Fire. Nice choice.
All right. Rest in peace, buddy.
That's all right. He got the lane into the tower, at least.
He did. He did his job there, and it's a relatively short respawn. He already bought the TP. That's worth it.
We'll give it to him.
Yeah,
no,
I think
actually,
it's worth.
It's actually not that bad, to be honest. And he's not even going to bother TPing because the wave's going to be this far out and there's two supports, so he'll be here in time for the second one. If Jules... Alright, GG.
You're calling it? You're done?
Yeah. Alright, this is what you expect from this Magnus. That's what we talk about. Like, I feel like Disruptor is such a strong counter to this. It's going to be so good. Ben was kind of struggling a little bit with the laning phase as well, the Magnus last time. I don't think he's like 100% comfortable on it yet. At least compared to like when you watch Ice 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 or something. He will steal a little bit of this experience though.
Yeah, he kind of knows what he can get away with a little bit. And he also has that little charge away if he needs to. Alright, up top our Sand King has to play ultra safe here. But
oh my god, Disruptor makes the best noise being denied.
What does he say?
He just goes, ha! Just like, that's it. Some mocking bark of a laugh. It actually sounds like Suns fan or something. I don't know. That was something else.
You know, Disruptor is like my fourth most played hero of all time. And I just, either I don't deny enough or I never acutely paid attention to that. But now that you mention it, it is quite humorous.
It's like when you first find out what Beastmaster, I remember when he first started getting picked in pro games, I did not know what the noise was that was happening when he was picking up bounty runes when they were first
oh,
introduced.
Oh yeah, he just like weirdly grumbles. Oh, Nana yeah. Could be in some trouble here. Gonna get ignited, fire blasted, held in place. Ah, Fu with a nice crush to save the day. As Sunstrike comes in, it will be off the mark. They won't be able to snap up the Ember Spirit just yet. In fact, Ember Spirit looking to take out the Slardar with him, but
nice
he turns
play.
It around. Nana able to score credit for that kill. Jules is fresh out of mana. He's got nothing else he can do. Ah, Fu just going to go end it all for these big boys. But well played by that Slardar.
Yep, gets to deny and everything. 200 gold goes to his Invoker. Great start for him. If we look as well at the other lasses across the board, not having a good time up top. Oh, he's got a Quelling Blade queued up because his life is not easy. I guess only level 2 so far versus almost level 4 here for the lifestealer. He'll start to catch up though once this caustic comes into play. And you gotta be careful. You never know, man. You tag up some of these caustics. Look at Azji. He's like, oh shit. That's where stuff gets a little bit dicey, right? Some of these explosions, they hurt.
I thought you were making a pun on his name when you said, aw shit.
Oh, no, I'm not that clever, Andy.
Yeah, that was about to be a little bit savage, even for you.
No, you can use that sometime, though.
I don't intend to. I don't really want to call a professional Dota player shit. I think he's earned that respect. Anyway, Slark farming up pretty nicely, top of our last hit chart. He's got himself some little booties working on that Ring of Aquila. And of course, Ember Spirit winning the mid lane, but you really expect that, at least in terms of last hits. Invoker, he's just taking a little bit of damage here, but nothing too violent. RR really would like that rune. He's able to get it and bro strike his way to freedom. Is there going to be any follow-up from that? Well, they can't catch him for a lift, so it appears not. Meanwhile, Invoker, underneath his own tower, could be in some trouble. Nice little tornado to disjoint everything going on, and this Ember Spirit, she's taking too much damage. She's going to go down, but they will get the Invoker killed after all. Jules with a nice little ignite, burning him down. And there we go. Another kill comes in as the support duo heads towards the mid lane and finally makes himself useful. 4.5 minutes in, really good time for that first kill in the mid lane.
Man, Bimbo really committed onto that one.
Ah, he was all in, dude. Tier 1 towers mean nothing to him.
Oh, that Sunstrike. That must have hit Jules. He just barely lived. Pulse one. Just runs back. Like, taunting, basically. Oh, he thought there was going to be a ward because that Sunstrike actually hit. Damn, what a player. Look at that. Look at that. See, you hit a baller Sunstrike, guys, and you waste 100 gold. Because you're like, nah, he obviously has a ward if you hit that Sunstrike.
He's just that good, dude. Well, either way, he's just gonna go clear out these little side camps up here on the high ground, and I mean, are we just first sight of Midas? What are we thinking about for this Invoker?
Oh yeah, Midas gaming for sure.
I've seen some Invokers go back for that like ultra old school, just cold snap, grab the first item earned before like anything, before boots. Oh, so refreshing. Yeah, lift up here. They do have the Burrow Strike. Oh, look at that. Dive away, but you're still going to get chewed on by the Lifestealer. Jit claims another victim. They're just going right back to farming.
Spared you future loss. Mercy on the overall. A little bit behind the Slark, not too bad. So it doesn't really depend on how much farm the Lifestealer has, though. It's more so about Afu. He's sitting at about 700 gold here in the mid lane, just waiting for this wave to hopefully push his way so he can get himself a little bit of gold while his Invoker is away farming neutrals. Ben left his own devices down here. Ninja Boogie's getting some free experience while Slark jungles a little bit because he's hit 6. Your standard stuff.
Jules, he's hasted. He wants to get this show going. Tosses out a little ignite onto Nana. It's just going to be burning under tower, but I think Ember Spirit maybe learned his lesson about going full Divi. Just wants to relax and get some last hits.
Seems like they really want another kill on Nana. Pressure that they have there, but instead it'll be bottom lane that they put their focus on. They have a glimpse back.
Glimpse onto Ben. He's going to be able to go and skewer himself through that kinetic field, so not going to get stuck in Disruptor's trap. And with the glimpse already committed, they got nothing else to catch up to him, so Ogre makes his way all the way to the bottom lane and doesn't find anything for his trouble. It's could really use some more levels there on Jules.
Well, even if you can't force the skewer before the glimpse, it's gonna be a pretty hard kill. But Miracle treads, and he just starts heading in towards that Shadow Blade, looking to be the Kickstarter for his team, trying to get around the map, provide some vision for the Disruptor to catch people out of place. And hoping for a quick jumpstart kill, but not going to find one top lane. RR just going to hide himself away. Means his level 6 won't be able to be used for the Epicenter, but typically we don't need that to like level 8 or something anyway. Not a big deal. Helps him stay in lane and grab said levels.
It's very calm. End of the laning stage here, but once we actually start getting into those, you know, big 4-man, 5-man smoke rotations, it is going to heat up very quickly. I think the cores are just concerned with, you know, getting some of their items online before that actually happens, before they're completely rotated upon and picked off. So, we got Ben, again, just sitting back, working on the mana boots. He's got them very shortly.
Gonna be a little bit of a window here for the Radiant, too. His Ninja Boogie just hit 6. Can probably get a smoke sent out and try and get a kill. Yeah, he's going to TP home immediately because they haven't given any space to X-Nova. There hasn't been any rotations in the jungle from Ajit whereas our Slark has, of course, like farmed up through all of this and given that over to Ninja Boogie. So Exno was a little bit behind. He has just done the small camp, and he'll pull the mid too. But would really like to see them try and make a play here with this level 6 on the Ninja Boogie as soon as possible. And it looks like the goal will be top. They're already smoking 2 up. Ninja Boogie's running. Dire vision. They have to hear. They're not going to spot break.
They're going in. Rubik, there's really not much he can do. He's level 5. Can't even steal something for his own good. And, well, lifts up the bug. Tries to throw him back, but still going down. RR getting the money for that one, so moving him closer and closer towards that blink. Meanwhile, Miracle, he rotated around, did a nice little tour of the dire side of the jungle, but didn't find what he was looking for, didn't find easy kills, so he's just going back into lane, trying to keep his net worth up. And I mean, switching over to net worth, that's levels. There we go. He's doing alright for himself. He's right behind the Lifestealer.
They're just waiting down here. I don't know if they'd have the damage, though. Be pretty tough. Maybe if Afu was 6.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Hey, they got one. Invoker gets stuck in that little static storm. He does manage to make his way out, but one more tick of the Thunderstrike would have done it if the right click hadn't. So very well played by the Disruptor, realizing it's now the crucial time for him to rotate, getting on it, buying the smoke, and going for it.
All right, excellent. So very well played. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. 550. Ooh, good courier grab. All right.
Where'd that go down?
Just the top lane. It was the armlet recipe from RR, so that'll delay the rotations from Ajit. Ah, shit. I lost my armlet. See, that's what I was aiming for. Like, calling him shit.
No, I can't handle puns.
Accuse me as if I'm
going to
flame players.
No, you would
typical,
never.
Typical. No, not me. No, it really was a great rotation by Ninja Boogie into the mid lane too. Just the fact you're using the 6 to clear core invoker. I mean, that's the dream. Just 2 supports at kill. Kind of insane, actually. Helps them out so much in terms of their overall gold. I mean, they're above both dire supports now. Their levels, they're also above both dire supports. And Afu, my god, dude, get a life. This is all he can do is just soak this experience. And hope they make a bad dive onto Ben.
Everyone going forward. Sorry for the
top
little bit of lag.
Time.
That's on our side. We're trying to host 2 streams at once. I asked the other stream to take it down a notch. I think they're trying to stream at a ridiculous bit rate. But either way, here we go. RP threatened out. Static Storm committed. It's not really going to hold anyone in place. Instead, they're isolating Afu, and they do get him down. Looks like Ben is able to find his way into the trees and TP out. But,
that was a nice play.
Yeah.
Oh,
they're still
chasing.
Going forward. Ember Spirit going to be going in. X-Nova with the Stolen Remnants. The RP dumped out, but That's Ember Spirit just going in. No remorse. The Flame Guard doing some serious work on this Rubik. No way.
That was toasty.
Oh, that's brutal. I mean, I don't think Ember Spirit gets out of this one, but he can die a hero. Oh my god.
I wonder if he forgot. Maybe he's not an Ember player and he forgot that the root will now stop or something. That was his escape plan. I'm not sure.
He just lived, dude. Did you see that?
Deliver.
Jeez. What a
player.
Oh,
that was so funny.
X-Nova. Fall from grace after that Crystal Maiden game. But it's okay. He's a Ruby against the Sand King. He's going to redeem himself. He's stolen the Burrow Strike. One of the best heroes to be up against is a Ruby there. And do we have our armlet here yet? Or oh my god, still 20 more seconds, I think. Now RR has his blink. Alrighty, Esky, all cylinders firing. Game time. Oh, why didn't my score marker work? Holy, I must have turned it off. I'm the worst, guys.
That's a report right there. Enjoy low priority.
Yeah, low priority adminning.
We're talking about these little, if you follow my mouse, little score doodads over here. Warriors Gaming should have one big yellow blop right there.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, here we go. X-Nova will get dragged back, brought into the river, and just punished.
Oh, go right into a ward, but detected. I guess Miracle flying on past, like, yeah, there's a ward there. All right, guys, I updated the title. I'm so sorry.
I updated the title. Did it not save?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe it didn't.
I definitely did. Did you refresh your browser?
I just did, Andy.
I'm sorry. I tried. I did update the title like immediately after the first series. I felt so proud that I remembered.
I put a score in the title.
Oh, well, aren't you fancy?
Yeah, that's just really special. Game is still on, it seems. Bot's ready here.
Thanks for that hardcore analysis.
No problem, guys. Pinball looking to come in up top. They have no waves nearby, though, so he has to go.
Oh, he's in the Black Dragon. He's coming down, and he's going to be going in. Ninja Boogie. Going to be going forward. Nice static storm. Good reaction time. Ajit still will be able to find a kill. Now Miracle running for his life. We've got Sand King ready to go in. Burrow striking four heroes into the RP. Holy moly. X Nova, though, still alive and able to hit. From the sidelines, that was one hell of a wombo combo. It is just such a tragedy that they have to end just a little bit of damage short. Look how low Ajit and X Nova are not able to finish it. And well, mid lane, Invoker just gets dropped.
Oh, I actually can't believe how close that was to being like four kills.
That Burrow strike.
I mean, he still saved him, I guess. Good. So it was still sick, but damn. Like, if X Nova had died there, and then his caustic explosion. That could have been bad.
Damn. Alright. RR, keep your eyes on that guy. He's ready to go in with the blink four-man Burrow strikes under the epicenter. If only there was just like one more hero there, a Slarkhead. One more Dark Pact would have made that a little bit easier to actually clean up. But still, keeping WG in their place. Overall net worth right now is pretty heavily in favor of Mineski. Similar story with XP as well.
Alright, Ogre Gaming. Looks good. Tower mid. And Rage Potato, Mr. Bimbo, still working towards his Blink Dagger.
Alright, there's about 10 minutes left till invites drop. Just want to, once again, plug the rest of our studio on MoonDuckTV2, twitch.tv/MoonDuckTV2. We are doing a live What the Duck on the invites and reactions and predictions and whatnot, so feel free to head on over there. But here we go. We still got a game going on, and that is going to be a Magnus. Stuck between a rock and a hard place, just plummeted off. It took four heroes and an ult to kill him, but he is dead nonetheless.
Yeah, that's just good smoke. And you can see how much he's been punished this game, too. Like, this was the most important thing by far for the Mineski draft, and they did it. Like, they understood what went wrong in the previous game and how to correct it, and that was to not allow this Magnus to just farm up into a Blink Dagger. Like, he's so poor, he's not even going to be able to finish up his helm first, I don't think. He'll just save up the full gold and head into the Blink Dagger instead because of how you need it. And without that blink, it makes it more difficult for Afu and our Lifesteer to get stuff going. So, we just end up with a slowed down Ben and a slowed down Ajit.
Everyone continuing to farm up, just looking for that next big item. Slark gonna be finishing off his Echo Saber, so he's hitting... Well, not exactly twice as fast, but he'll get some double hits in there. He'll work on it.
Yeah, and now it's them who can just be aggressive. Now, the one thing is they aren't really a five-man kind of lineup. They still want to farm up a little bit, so it does open up the window, I think, to these kind of ganks, which they're going in for now. We go Dire Vision. They see Sand King. Just spotted through that line and spotted him again. Smoke still not popped.
There we go. Smoke popped. Oh, nice. I know someone's there, but Burrow Strike in. They're trying to juke and jive this guy. Sunstrike will still finish off RR, but Afu could be in some trouble. Gonna get burned up, and now Miracle's ready to go forward. This could be the start of Slark's big snowball. They get two trapped under the static storm. Kinetic field holding back for Ajit, and he's gonna hit the deck. This is three heroes down on the side of Warriors Gaming Unity, trading only for a Sand King right at the start.
All right, gank failed. This is that... Slardar Lifestealer where it didn't work, but we don't have the levels in the Magnus, like we don't have max and power yet. And we're also not really seeing that connection between the Lifestealer and the Magnus too much, so this is where the plan probably is going to alter for Warriors Gaming. We talk about the secondary strat where they're just going to try and farm up this Lifestealer to ridiculousness. Still going for ganks when they can, but it's definitely the point where he needs to get on the grind, because he's about 3k behind Slark at this point. Kind of scary. Full item here. And that item for Slark is looking to be a Silver Edge next.
Alright, so very calm game between punctuated points of like massive 5-on-5 fighting. It's just everyone do their own thing, everyone just sit back and be calm and work on your items, and then all of a sudden just bloodbath. I like that part.
And nice little ancient stack here as well for Ajit, so he has the empower going. He's getting that mad money.
Damn, look at it roll in. Whew. Alright, nice little play there, about 1,000 more gold in his bank.
I still do think they have the stronger chance, honestly, of, well, not necessarily winning this game for sure, because there is a pretty hefty lead now on the Radiant side. They're up to like 12.5k, so more than likely Mineski should be able to close this one out, but there's so many more options on this draft than there would be on the enemy draft, I guess is what I'm trying to say. If they were this far behind, like, one good pickoff can immediately lead into Roche for them. They have very good high ground defense with RP plus Aghanim's Invoker, but Nana, yeah.
Nice play there. They have Dust, but they have no real way of reinitiating Tornado. Clips onto the Sand King. He's going to go ahead and get Cold Snapped, but I don't think he's done so. Meanwhile, down bottom, Ajit, like you mentioned, once he gets that empower and starts hanging with the Magnus, he can start clawing people absolutely apart. The Disruptor's still going to be dead. Jump in from the Ember Spirit. Doing a little
still
bit of work.
Still have RP, so...
Yeah.
Needs to be a little cautious here. In fact, all of them do is they chase, but...
Oh. Rubik picks himself up some Searing Chains, but he might be burning down himself. Very nice kill there from Miracle, just jumping in and cleaning up the remains. So he's now well on his snowball. He's got himself 4-0-4 as a score. So once Slark gets off to a good start, it can be really difficult to stop him.
They do have a really nice chase, too. On the side of Mineski, just between a Slark, a Disruptor, and an Ember Spirit. It's very difficult to get out of those situations, especially if there's any residual vision up ahead or something like that from previous engagements. But currently, Radiant, they just relying on some creeps and RR up here. Sneaking his way through the tree lines.
Does he make it out? He done it. He's trying to go for that Burrow Strike all the way across the river. He is now thoroughly sandwiched. Is going to be able to Burrow Strike, but not far enough. There he goes. There's the Blink. Baiting out all the rest of the dire heroes. And nice little static storm there from the Disruptor. Taking advantage of the fact that everyone's jumping in, but Lifestealer makes it into a Siege Creep, and that's going to be the end of the fight. Sand King does escape alive, just barely. No blood is shed.
Nice static storm. Ninja Boogie. But that is a little bit of space created for Nana at the very least. He's catching way up. Holy. It's like only 800 by an Ember. All right, that might change. No. He can't live. Can he live? He's got pounds. Oh, Deafening Blast. Oh, Nana. What a player. Oh.
I'm going to be 100% real. I caught none of that on camera, and your noises were fantastic.
Are you joking? How do you not?
I was definitely tabbed into the Skype reading about production issues happening right now. That's why the What the Duck stream is temporarily offline. I apologize. I'm trying to sort it out. It will be back on twitch.tv. I'm sorry. I caught the very end when Invoker TP'd out. I'm trying to make sure the stream doesn't crash for the entire house.
Well, fine. Well, to briefly summarize, Nana was gone on by Slark, Ghost Walk, but then there was Dust from Slark, so then he had to make his way away with an Ice Wall, and then mid-pounce, he got him with a Deafening Blast, and then he went for the TP, and he got out. It was pretty sick.
I'm real sorry about that, guys.
Yeah, you just, ruined Nana's professional
career,
by the way.
That's like a bold-faced T-Tauris right there. Oh, there we go! Another nice Burrow Strike, immediate kill onto Afu, Static Storm. It does its job, make sure no one is there to re-engage. Nana still moving forward. There's Ember Spirit dropping the Veil of Discord. Now magic damage is going to hurt, and there we go. Easy kill onto the Magnus, who died with his RP still intact. X-Nova is revealed, and well, he's trying to scoot himself away, but he's going to be killed off. It's only the Lifestealer left alive, so he's going to be hiding in his base. This is Mineski just feeling it. They got their groove, and they're riding it.
Yeah, game plan successful. shut down Magnus. Eliminate that super early game and power sort of strategy. And have heroes that aren't susceptible to these big ganks. Afu's looking for it, but it's only two. Jeez, they maybe unbeknownst to them, it's actually no one else nearby. Perhaps could have found a kill on the support, but more than likely, Miracle would bring them down. And well, no reason to commit either. They're not even going to lose the tier 3.
Jit, looking like a nice target here. Everyone's smoked up. Sand King is channeling up the Epi, and yeah, that's just a not nice situation to find yourself in. RP's galore as Ben tries real hard. Well,
triple kill, miracle god.
That's what happens when you don't punish a Slark. He's now 9-0-7. He had a real free lane, started out slow, but he is just rolling in it right now. Very well played, top of the net worth chart by far. And he's going for a Radiance because it's freaking... Oh no, that's our Ember. Our Slark is just got a Silver Edge. I'm sorry, I hit the wrong hotkey. I'm all over the place, I'm sorry.
It's alright, Andy, I know, you're struggling over there. It's not your fault. It's okay,
sorry.
You're getting a pass today.
Okay.
This time.
I'll shape up tomorrow, I promise.
Alright. Acceptable. You got to keep it together, Annie. You have a long day ahead of you.
I have a very long day today. But here we go. Sand King gonna go ahead and get cold snapped up. Nana still looking for the chase, able to grab him in the Yules, the ice wall as well. That Sand King is slow and dead. And there's gonna be Slark trying to avenge his lost brother, but doesn't have quite enough damage to burst down that Slardar all in one go. Meanwhile, Disruptor trying to make easy work out of everyone. Hodget, just gonna be sitting in the Static Storm. I mean, there's nothing he can do. Deafening Blast will hold back the Slark for now, but he's still ready to go again. Got off a really nice ult. Ben gonna be taking him down to the low ground, but the GG is already called out as this Slark cannot be stopped. Mineski looking incredibly strong this game, walking all over Warriors Gaming Unity, and we're taking this to a game number 3.
All right, great job by Mineski. Take that Ogre first overall. Deny the combination of the Ogre and the Magnus. WG still go into it, but...
Without double steroids, it looks like it wasn't quite enough. Roid Rage wasn't there. Just normal Lifestealer Rage, perhaps. And they really shut down that Magnus. Like, absolutely obliterated him. He had no impact this game at all. So, I credit that to the victory for sure. I think the Disruptor was a very solid pick, too. In terms of, like, the laning. Made it very difficult for him to actually get last hit, stay in lane. And exceptional play overall by Mineski. So, looking forward to game 3. As it is 1-1, despite what my poor timer said. And you know what, my fix, it's there already, guys. There will be score markers next game.
Aren't you special?
I really am.
All right, so sit tight. Quick break before game number 3. We're back with more Mr. Cat action in just a few minutes.